I welcome on behalf of MIT University of Organic Agriculture. Earlier we studied about plant analysis, how we analyze plant samples, and today we will be also studying about plant analysis. It is a different method that is called DRIS method, DRIS method of plant analysis. What is DRIS method? That will be discussed in details. Earlier we studied about dry ashing method, wet digestion method of plant analysis. In dry ashing methods, plant samples were dried on crucible, kept on oven for 500 degrees Celsius, and the powdered form of plant is mixed with acids like nitric acid or any other acids for determination of nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, calcium. In wet digestion methods, crucibles are not used, ovens are not used, only mixture of acids are used like mixture of hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid and perchloric acid, that is triacid mixture or tetraacid mixtures are used for the analysis of several nutrients in plant laboratory. And this is another method that is called DRIS method in plant analysis or leaf analysis. We can analyze leaves, we can analyze plant parts, different parts of plants, plant tissues with the help of DRIS method. So you can see, suppose what is DRIS? DRIS, the full form of DRIS is Diagnosis and Recommendation Integrated System. This is integrated system, means many systems are attached. Several systems are attached, that is called integrated system. In integrated system, we study different nutrients. We study several nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium as a whole. So DRIS is a new approach for interpreting leaf or plant analysis, and the scientist whose name was Baufils in 1973 developed this method that is called Diagnosis and Recommendation Integrated System. Now we come back to the chart. You can see there are three arrows. You can see one arrow is named nitrogen upon potassium. You can see this arrow is called nitrogen is to potassium arrow. This row is called, the middle row is called nitrogen is to phosphorus ratio, and this row is called potassium is to phosphorus ratio. And there are data on the chart. You are seeing different data. Suppose potassium is to phosphorus ratio, at bottom it is just 4.14. The ratio increased to 4.77, then the ratio increased to 6.2. The ratio is increasing towards the arrow. You can see all values are increasing towards the arrow. So Baufils developed this system and he found the average value of different ratios. What is the ratio? Ratio is the volume of one nutrient divided by another nutrient. So the ratio between nitrogen and phosphorus is 8.2. Ratio between nitrogen and potassium is 1.57, and the ratio between potassium and phosphorus is 5.39. This was the ratio which comes at the interaction of the three lines. All the three lines interact with each other, and the interaction point show this value, like 8.24 n upon p. This is n upon p line, and this value is 8.2. For n upon k, nitrogen ratio potassium, this line, the value is 1.57 here. And for the last, potassium is to phosphorus ratio, this is the line of potassium is to phosphorus ratio, and the interaction point, the value comes 5.39. And this interaction point is the best place, a best maximum yield can be obtained at this point. This DRIS recommendation shows that or recommend that the best yield can be obtained at the point of interaction. And if the values are out of apart or far from this point, then the yield is decreasing. So this is an integrated system for all nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. This nutrient considered ratio, nutrient concentration ratio, that is more important than the individual element concentration. Individual content is less important and the ratio is more important. Balance ratio of nutrients should be there. All nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium should be balanced, means neither less nor more. All the three nutrients are must be in balance amount so that maximum yield can be obtained. This is the concept of this method. You can see the method. This is a relative balance between nutrients by means of index values. The index values are either positive or negative, and the zero, when it is neither positive nor negative, then it is best. Then it is considered best for yield potential. This reveals not only the limiting nutrients, but also show the order of nutrients which are becoming limiting. The concept of DRIS was first developed by Boffins in 1973, and the full form is Diagnosis and Recommendation Integrated System. This is a comprehensive system, means many systems are there, the systems are integrated, the systems are balanced, there are mixture of different nutrients. You can see nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium in balanced amount, and that is the best for maximum yield potential. We have studied the ratios like nitrogen is to phosphorus, nitrogen is to potassium and potassium is to phosphorus. And if these ratios are better, like average value, well established value are there, and if it is on the same point, then the yield potential is best. So DRIS mainly uses nutritional balancing concept. If the all nutrients are in balanced amount, then there will be high possibility of yield. Then there will be no deficiencies or no excess in plants. So another factor is BNI. What is BNI? BNI stands for Boffins Nutrient Index. This was also developed by the scientist Boffins. Boffins Nutrient Index. High concentration of one nutrient can decrease the concentration of other nutrients. If we add one nutrient, it also affects the other nutrients. There is interaction between all of these nutrients. So it is a best and balancing method of nutrient application, and now it is becoming popular for nitrogen, potassium and phosphorus. It is also becoming popular for calcium, sulfur and magnesium. Other elements are also applied in this system. Second, the entire population of observation is divided into two subpopulation on the basis of vigor, quality and health. You can see different elements are expressed, and the percentage of nitrogen in dry matter or ratios. The mean value for each of these forms of expression then constitute a diagnostic norms. You can see the table. There is a deficiency system and deficiency prone, sufficient level, more than sufficiency and excess. These are the different status. How it is calculated? If the DRIS value is negative, that is less than 0, less than 0 value is called negative value, and this negative value, this negative index show deficiency of nutrients. If it is greater than 0, then it is called, if it is less than 0 and DRIS is greater than, DRIS value is greater than the balanced index average. If it is greater than average but less than 0, it is also prone to deficiency level, and the sufficient level is equal amount, exactly equal amount is there. Equal amount means the value is equal to nutritional balance index average. If the index average is equally with the matching with the sample, then it is called sufficient level. Now if the value is positive, then it is excess of nutrient. If the value is more positive and the value is more than the balanced index average, then it is excess or negative. You can see the negative value. Type of nutrient application is also given. So, diagnosis and recommendation integrated system is a new approach. The scientist who developed, that is the name is Bob Hills. He worked on his laboratory, and it is University of Natal, South Africa. You must also remember, whether it may be a quiz question. Bob Hills worked at South Africa in the University of Natal. It is a comprehensive system. It is a balanced nutrient system which identify all nutritional factors limiting the crop production. This can identify all nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, which are balancing the crop production. So it is very important for applying balanced amount of nutrition for crop production. You can see these are the different signs. If the sign is horizontal, the value is within the inner circle, and if the value is inside the inner circle, then it is one of the best level. The inner circle is the best, is the optimum level of nutrition, and the cross of the point of intersection is the best point or best level of recommendation. And inner circle is the optimal level, outer circle is medium level, and out of the circle it is poor level. If we can say the air potential is minimum in the outer area and the air potential is maximum in the inner circle, and the air potential is medium in the outer circle. And you can see the horizontal arrow. Horizontal arrow means the value is inside the inner circle, and there is curved arrow, the value is in the outer circle. If the value is in the outer circle, whether it is increasing or decreasing, the value is in the outer circle, and the value is out of the circle, that is very low or very high condition. Either they are very low condition or very high condition. Either they are very increasing or either they are very decreasing, poor condition. So these symbols are there, you can see. And some examples are already here. Here is nitrogen 2.34%. Here the point is appearing like comma, but really it is point. 2.34% nitrogen. This is an example in sugarcane field. Phosphorus is 0.39 and potassium is 1.17. And if we calculate the ratio, it comes 6. NP ratio 6, NK ratio 2, KP ratio 3. Here NP ratio is coming less than recommended value. The recommended value is more than, you can see 8. You can see the recommended value is 8.2. N is to K 1.57 and K is to be 5.39. So this is the average value, established value, and we compare this value by the new samples. So the new sample, we can say that this ratio is lower, this ratio is higher, and this ratio is again lower than the original reference. So which the ratio is lower, both ratio is lower, why it is lower? And the nutrient, concerned nutrient is applied when its concentration is lower. You can see potassium is more important, most important. The second part is nitrogen is important, and the third priority is phosphorus. So first potassium is added under Driss method. The second fertilizer is nitrogen, which is added, and the last is phosphorus. So this is the method. First you can see 50. This sign shows that phosphorus is lower. So here the dose of phosphorus was given. Again, now potassium is showing that this level is lower. Then again potassium is added here, 60. Again it is showing that now nitrogen is limiting factor. Not nitrogen, you can see this one. Phosphorus is again limiting factor. Then phosphorus dose is again increased. And here you can see nitrogen and phosphorus both are, nitrogen is also limiting now. So at last nitrogen was given. After giving the nitrogen content, you can see phosphorus and potassium level is in the inner circle, so it is good now. And this is in outer circle, so again you can see the level of nitrogen was increased because this was in outer circle. and in the last you see all are horizontal lines. Horizontal lines means all nutrients have become in inner circle, and inner circle is the best place for best option, and it is now the soil is best conditioned for maximum growth of plants. And so this is the importance of tree system in our agriculture. So tree system have many advantages over other systems. They are balanced nutrition, they are providing several nutrients, and they are controlling the limitation or critical point of nutrients and maintaining the balance in soil application. So now routine use of drips is being adopted. It is also adopted for other crops like sugarcane, pineapple and many others. Crop logging of drips means in a standing crop we are calculating the fertilizer recommendation. That is called crop logging of drips system. We are calculating fertilizer recommendation in the standing crop. We are examining whether the nutrients are losing, how the nutrients are not available to plants, what are the limitations in the standing crops. Then this method is called crop logging method. Then we study crop requirement in the standing crops. These are the formula. Isotopic dilution technique for drips. This method also determines the amount of phosphorus applied to soil. It is a function of amount of phosphorus applied to soil. Available phosphorus in soil can be determined with the help of amount of phosphorus applied to soil, fraction of phosphorus taken by the plant, a constant multiply total phosphorus in the plant, a constant multiply total phosphorus taken by the plant, and this is calculation based, and the amount of available phosphorus is determined by isotopic dilution technique. What is isotopic dilution technique? This is an example. Suppose we have to calculate number of fish in a pond. So there are isotopic fishes are also there. Isotopic fishes are added into the ponds. Isotopic means marked. Marked fishes are added into the ponds, and after some time again the population is counted, and the ratio is obtained between normal fish and the marked fish or labeled fish. And with the help of this ratio, we can multiply by the number of marked fish. Then it gives the total number of fish in a pond. Critical level of nutrients in plants, already said that up to critical level, plants grow rapidly. So it is very must to apply nutrients at least to the critical levels. Below the critical levels, the growth is reduced. Growth can be reduced severely when we are applying less amount of nutrients than the critical limits. And the level of critical levels are given. Sulfur in plants should be 0.15 to 0.2%. Calcium in plants should be 0.2%. Magnesium in plants should be 0.1 to 0.2%. Zinc in plants, it can be a quiz question. Zinc in plants should be less than 15 to 20 ppm. Magnesium in plants less than 20 ppm. Copper in plants less than 4 ppm. Iron in plants less than 50 ppm. Boron in plants less than 20 ppm, and this is the minimum molybdenum implant must be less than 0.1 ppm. These are critical limits implants. Critical limits implants are different than the critical limits in soils. So, DRIS system, diagnosis and research integrated system, has been considered a better technique for plant nutrient recommendation, for fertilizer recommendation, and the whole world is following this new technique due to its balanced application of NPK in our plants. Thank you.